But the mandatory ones mean you must provide, yeah.
And what happens if you refuse?
If you refuse, you can be arrested and brought to the station. And then you'll be asked to give a specimen of blood or urine or breath at that point. People sometimes think, well, if I don't give a sample, they've got nothing to test. And if they're nothing to test, they can't prove that I had anything in my system. And that's true. But if you fail to refuse to give a sample, you're going off the road for 4 years, which is the outside maximum. The maximum you could be ever put off the road for in drink or drug driving and blood, urine, or breath is 3. But if you refuse, you get 4. It's really punished if you refuse. So the idea you might avoid it by not giving a specimen is absolutely disastrous. You'll get more than the maximum for that. But if you fail the breath test, you're brought to the local station, and then you're asked to either give us, you're brought to the intoxilizer room, or the room where the intoxilizer machine is kept, and then you're brought through the process of blowing into that machine to give what's known as 2 specimens of your breath. Sometimes the intoxilizer machine isn't working. In that case, then it reverts back to blood or urine, where a doctor is then called. But if you fail a breath test, you'll be arrested and brought to the station, yeah. Road traffic is something that really affects people a great deal. I mean, what you discover with road traffic is that it means a lot to people, because if they're being prosecuted for drink driving or sometimes drug driving, dangerous driving, careless driving, driving without whatever, speeding, the consequences of those things are pretty severe sometimes for people. And the people that I tend to represent all tend to be quite nervous of court. They've never been to court, and they're in some cases really quite sometimes petrified about court. So a lot of what I do is try and walk them through that process of what to expect on that day and the next day perhaps. But I try and guide them through the process, because it's completely alien to them. They've never been there.